This conference will now be recorded.
Let's restart. So we have seen the difference between what inner join and what left outer join. So let us take an example to understand that. So this is the requirement. See, I want a selection screen, okay, where we need to read the range of what? Customer numbers. We need to read the range of customer numbers. Whenever I execute this, I should get the customer data as well as the sales order data. Okay, the input I am going to give is customer number from KN11 table. On executing this, I should display the data which includes customer data as well as the sales order header data. Okay, so I need to get what? What is the requirement here? Requirement is based on the entered customer range. Okay, based on the entered customer range, get the customer data. Okay, get the customer data from which table? KN11 table, and sales orders header data. Sales order header data from which table? VBAQ table of each customer using what? Single select query. So by using single select query, I need to get the data from what? Both the tables, KN11 table and what? VBAK table. So since I have to use only one select query, we should know what is the logically related field between these two tables. What is the relationship between these tables? Customer number is available in what? Both the tables. So KNA1 dot customer number is equal to what? VBAK dot customer number. This is a logically related field between the two tables. KNA1 dot customer number is equal to VBAK dot customer number. So first let us focus on generating the selection screen. So I'll create the report program. Right, inner join, what? Two tables. Type of program is executable program. Let me save it in the local object. Done. So first we require what? A selection screen. Okay, so what I'll do is let me do it in the same program. So I require a selection screen where I need to read the range of what? Customer numbers. So to read the range of input values, we already know we have to go for select option. So first I'll declare a variable v_customer_number type what? KN11-customer_number. Then I'll use select options so_customer_number for v_customer_number. Default I'll give something 1000 to 1010. Done. So when I execute this, no syntax errors. It's a warning related to the KN11 structure. Just ignore it. I'll generate the selection text for this. Right, so this is a selection screen where I am reading the range of what? Customer numbers. On executing this, I should get the data from what? Two tables. So I should decide what fields I need to get. Okay, so if you see the requirement, I need to get the customer number and customer city from which table? KN11 table. And from header table, VBAK table, I should display the sales order number, date and what? Time of creation. Okay, so fields to be retrieved is what from KNN table I need to get what customer number and what city ORT01, and from VBAK table I need to get sales document number VBLN, sales document creation date ERDAT, sales document creation time ERZAT. So overall I want 5 fields in the report. Okay, so they are the 2 fields from KNN table and 3 fields from VBAK table. So I require one internal table now, only one internal table, because we are going to fetch the data using only what, one single select query. If it is 2 different select statements, I would have taken what, 2 different internal tables. But the agenda is what, by using one select query I should be able to get the data from multiple table. So that's why I require an internal table which contains the fields from both the tables. So I'll set types begin of, I'll set TY underscore customer underscore sales. Okay, what are the fields you want? Customer number type KNN customer number, and I want the customer city ORT01 type KNN ORT01. Then I'll take sales document number VBLN type VBAK-Weblen. Then I'll take ERDAT type VBAK-ERDAT. Then I want the time also ERDAT type VBAK-ERZAT. Then end of TY underscore customer underscore sales. Based on this, I'll create an internal table T underscore customer sales type table of what? TY underscore customer underscore what sales. Then I require a work area, so W underscore customer underscore sales type TY underscore customer underscore what sales. Done. Okay, now we need to get the data. So whenever we click on this execute button on the selection screen, what is the event triggered? Start of selection. So I'll say in the start of selection event, in the start of selection event, let me get the get what, get customers and their what sales data. Okay, so I'll say perform get underscore customer underscore what sales. I'm just calling one subroutine. Okay, perform get customer sales. I'll double click on this subroutine, not found, does not exist, create the object. I'll create that in the main program. Instead of creating a new include, I'm doing it in the same program. Continue. Right, so we need to get the data from what, 2 tables using what, single select query. So how do we do it? Select what are the fields, customer number and what ORT01, from which table? KNN table. Then VBLN, ERDAT, ERZAT, they are the fields from what, second table. I can write all the fields in the same line, but just to increase the readability, I'm just differentiating it. Okay, from what, from KNN inner join what VBAK, and you have to compare the logical related field. What is the logical related field between the 2 tables? KNN tilt operator customer number is equal to VBAK of what customer number, VBAK of what customer number, where I have to compare with the customer range. Now what is the customer range I entered in the select option? What is that? SO underscore Kunnar. So where customer in, already we know whenever we compare with the select option, we have to use in operator. In what? SO underscore customer number. Okay, from KNN inner join, so also here I'll say into table. What is the internal table? T underscore customer underscore what sales. Okay, so let me check whether it is valid or not. When I do syntax check, I got an error. The column name customer number is ambiguous in the OpenSQL statement. The column name customer number is ambiguous. Ambiguous means here you are saying customer number, and how many tables you are specifying? 2 tables, KNN and what, VBAK. So this customer number field is available both in KNN table as well as in the VBAK table. So it is asking us from which table you want to get that particular customer number. I want this from KN1 table. So I'll say KN1 tilde operator. You have to compare that common field. If the field is part of multiple tables, from whichever table you want to get, you have to prefix that column name with the table name. Okay, done. Save it, check it. The column name ERDAT is ambiguous. Again, ERDAT column is there both in what? KN1 table as well as VBAK table. If you want, you can check it. If I go to ABAP dictionary, SC11, in the KN1 table, okay, in the KN1 table, let me search for what? ERDAT. Yes, ERDAT is there in what? The KN1 table. Let me check in VBAK table. In VBAK table also, that ERDAT column will be there. Okay, so since that column is part of two tables, okay, ERDAT is also there in what? VBAK table. So since it is part of two tables, the field which is part of multiple tables should be prefixed with the appropriate table name. So this I want it from VBAK table. Done. Save it, check it. Kunnar is ambiguous. Again, here also, this Kunnar is available in what? Both KNA1 table and what? VBAK table. So I'll say where KNA1 of what? Kunnar. So what is the understanding? If you're using joins in the select query, and if the retrieved field is part of both the tables, we need to prefix that common field. We need to prefix that field with the appropriate table name. Done. Save it, check it. No syntax error. So by using inner join, I'm trying to get the data from two tables into my internal table. Then I'll try to display. So I'll go back here. Here I'll say if what? T underscore customer underscore sales is not initial. If it is not initial, okay, I'll try to display it. So I'll say perform what? Display underscore what? Customer underscore sales. Else I'll just give a message, no data. No data, type what? I. End for if is what? End if. Okay, let me double click on the subroutine and loop the internal table and display it. So here I'll say what? Loop at what is the internal table? T underscore customer underscore sales into W underscore customer underscore sales end loop. Okay, then I'll try to display it. Right, what? W underscore customer sales hyphen customer number. Then the next field we are retrieved is city, ORT 01, then webland sales document number, then ERDAT creation date, then ERZAT. So I'm displaying the data. Check it, no syntax error, activate this. Okay, so when I execute, this is a range, this is a range. I gave what, 1000 to 1010. So if I go to this inner join two tables, I got the data here, but this data is not in sorted order. 1001 is there, 1002 is there, again 1000 is there, 1002, it's not in sorted order. So what I'll do just before displaying this, I'll try to sort. I'll say sort T underscore customer underscore sales by what? Customer number. So when I execute this, yes, I got the data. I got all the sales orders of this customer, 1000 city. Okay, this is a sales order, 1000 city. This is a sales order, same customer, but multiple sales orders. So they're all the sales orders of 1000 customer. If you scroll down, then you can observe here. They're all the sales orders of 1001. Then we are having the sales orders of 1002. So here, customer number and city is repeating. Customer number and city is what? Repeating. But I want the output something like this. Customer number and city should be displayed only once. Under that, I should display the sales orders of that particular customer. So how to avoid this repetition? we'll focus in the next class, but we are getting the data. Okay, so we are getting the sales orders of 1000, 1001 and 1002. Might be the other customers doesn't have any sales orders. Let me check how many sales orders are there. How do you check? You need to count the number of records now. So here I'll say describe table T underscore customer underscore sales. I'll just say write total records is what? Citation. Already we know describe statement. Already we know describe statement will count the number of records in the internal table and stores a count value in the system field what? Citation. In the system field citation. Okay. So let me just format color of here also format color 7 and here also format color off. Okay, so just to differentiate the output. So let me check how many records are there. When I execute, 450 records are there. Overall I got 450 records. Is it correct? Let me go and check in the VBAK table. I'll go to contents. Anyhow, only three customers are having the sales orders. So I have to check based on what customer number, nothing but sold to parties. So 1000 has got how many sales orders? 165. Then 1001, 181. How much? 346. 346. Is it correct? 1000. Yes, 165. And this is 181. How much? 346. Then 1002 has got 104. So overall how much? 450. 346 plus 104 is what? 450. Other customers doesn't have any sales orders. So 1003 to 1010, we don't have any sales orders. So I got the count as what? What? 450. The overall count I got is at 450. Only 1000 is having the sales orders, 1001 is having the sales orders, and 1002 is having the sales orders. Okay, so how to avoid this repetition of this output, we'll focus that in the next class. This is what? Inner join. What is the concept of inner join? It will pick up the matching rows from what? Left hand side and what? Right hand side table. So how did I use it? Select so and so, inner join VBAK. Inner join VBAK. Okay, something like this. Now let me keep this as it is. I'll just copy this program 53 to 54. The change I'll do is, instead of using inner join, let me use left outer join. I'll use what? Left outer join. What is the concept of left outer join? Even though there is no matching rows in the right hand side, it will still pick up the left hand side row. So I gave the range as 1000 to 1010. Only 1000, 1001, 1002 are in the sales orders. 1003 to 1010 doesn't have what? Sales orders. But still you can see here, what is the count I got? 455. 455. Why? You can see this is 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003. Yeah, you can see 1003, 1004, 1005. Might be customer number 1006 is not there in K11 table. That's why I didn't got. I got 1007 and again 8, 9 customers are not there. So that's why I got 1010. So what is happening here? See, you can observe here. This is the data from the left hand side table, K11 table. Right hand side, it is filled with what? Spaces and what? Zeros. If it is numeric date types, I'll get zeros and characters what? Space. Default value for date is 000 and time is also same. Understood. So always left outer join will have what? More records. I got how much? 455. Even though these customers doesn't have sales orders in the right hand side table, it is still picking that rows from the left hand side. Right hand side columns will be filled with what? Space. So always left outer join will consider all the rows from left hand side table. You'll always have more count compared with what? Inner join. And what is the other point you have to understand here? If the field is part of multiple tables, that field you have to prefix with what? The table name. You have to prefix with what? Table name. I can write like this, or let me, okay, I'll do it here only. I can write like this, or I can say I can define aliases here. Control C, or what I'll do here, I'll say select customer number. I'll not prefix with the table names. I'll not prefix with the table names, but instead what I'll do is I'll define the aliases for the tables. I'll define the alternative names for the tables. So here I'll say from KN1 as X. You can give any alias. Here I'll say as Y. Alternative name. For KN1, the alias I gave is what? X. For VBAK, I gave the alias is what? Y. So here I'll say what? X of Kunnar. Nothing but KN1 of Kunnar. Here I'll say Y of what? ERDAT. Again, this is X of Kunnar is equal to Y of what? Kunnar. And here also, this I want it from KN1 table, so X of Kunnar. So I can prefix the common field either with the table name or with the what? Alias names. There is no advantage here. You can go for either prefixing with the table name, or you can go for what? Alias. Alternative name. So I got the result. Same result I got, 455 records. Same thing I can do it for what? Inner join. In the inner join also, I can define the aliases for the table names. But the output should be displayed in this format. Here the customer data is repeating. Same data is repeating. So it should be displayed only once. Under that, I should display the corresponding sales orders. But as of today, our focus is how to use joins on our select query. Any questions, please ask me. So whenever we use left order join, it will consider each and every row from the left hand side table, even if there is no data in the right hand side table. Right hand side columns will be filled with default values, characters to space and number numeric data types to zeros. So that's what I got here. 1,003, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 6, 8, 9 I didn't got because those customers are not there in KN1 table. The left hand side table is what? KN1. So here if you see, here you can see, if I give 1,000 to 1,010, yes, you can see between 1,000 to 1,010, what are the customers available in the KN1 table? I'm having 1,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is not there, 8 and 9 is not there. That's why it didn't got in the result. And so tomorrow we'll see how to format this output. Okay, here data duplication is there. We'll focus on how to format this, and we'll focus on how to get the data from three tables. And we'll see there is any alternative way, instead of using joins, do we have any alternative way to get the data from multiple tables using single select query. So that part I'll discuss tomorrow. Any questions for today, please ask me. So I'll share both the recordings before the break and after the break. I'll put it as part 1 and part 1.1, something like that. So you can refer to the recordings. Done. So I'll wind off. We'll continue tomorrow with joins on three tables, and we'll see the alternates for joins.